Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining.
All right. Hello, 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 hello. Back for Dota 2 action, Mr. Cat. Second series of the day. Geek fam and returning for the encore as is Trust. And Strapback's here, joined by Annie. Annie, are you there?
Yep. Hi. Hello.
Hello.
10 seconds remaining.
Oh, my goodness. More Dota.
More Dota, dude. We saw Trust bring a series back from what looked like the depths of despair. They got wiped by Clutch in game one and brought it back after a 65-minute victory to a completely even series. So Trust are looking strong, probably riding a good momentum, but maybe they're a little fatigued. Geek fam also looking really strong themselves. I'm very interested to see this matchup.
Yeah, this was one of the more looked forward to ones lately, at least in terms of new teams, especially like Clutch and Geek fam. So I'm really looking forward to those two going up against each other, to be honest. But now that Trust have taken game number two, I wasn't, you know, after game one, Trust, I was a little bit worried, a little concerned. But
Rubik.
Dire team. And what we get yesterday with Geek fam. Courtesy of a Slardar into that we had that Legion Commander draft with the last pick PL for Teehee, which is really cool. Worked out exceptionally well out of the mid lane. Very good pick in the draft. Again, another kind of standard classic from his time drafting and playing with these mid jugs and mid PLs. And their second game, which didn't go quite as well, was a OD with the Earth Spirit. So some nice little combinations in the mid lane, but they weren't quite able to shut down the Tinker of TNC.
Whew. All right, starting things out with some familiar heroes. Geek fam grabbed the Weaver. We saw that played exceptionally well in the second game of our last series. Still unknown whether this is going to be support or core Weaver. Obviously, Weaver Aghs has been MVP of the series we've seen today, at least. Radiant. Now, with Vengeful Spirit picked up, what are the chances that Geek fam are going towards a Drow?
It's always going to be an option. You should definitely keep it in mind from Trust. Either prepare for it or ban it. It's just, it's all about Weaver Drow and Venge Drow also. Totally fine. But you also, at the same time, prepare for either of these to be position one, the Venge or the Weaver. And then you have to prepare for position one, three potentially, or even the four there for the Weaver too. So, also think about here. If you're trusting this draft, and they actually commit into a hero that doesn't have a lot of versatility, one would say, in the Undying. So, more likely to do well against some earlier fighting if it's going to be the Vengeful Spirit or a Drow based lineup. And then this might lean Geek fam now to look back towards like this position one Weaver, perhaps.
Legion going to be banned out, so not going to have that ultra hard scale and damage stack in core, but still lots for Geek fam to choose from. I mean, if Drow doesn't get banned out here, I will be thoroughly surprised, because Geek fam has the first pick going into this next round.
True. What I would say, though, is that with the Undying, Trust are saying, like, go ahead. 5 seconds basically. Like, yeah. We're happy if you want a Drow, because we're going to run at you. We're going to shit all over that Drow and throw her out the other side. Not that that'll necessarily happen, because Drow can still get out of control. Drow will allow Weaver to go position four, and then you have this Venge Weaver combo with a Drow. And yes, a Dora Runner again, another good hero up against the Drow. So we'll see if Trust won't let it go and hand it over to Geek fam. I'd be looking forward to it. They did beat a Drow lineup themselves, Geek fam. It was that TNC they tried twice yesterday with a lone druid kind of quick game. Worked game one, they had the sick Deso that came out. But then game two, when they had a lone druid and a Drow aura, it wasn't even enough for the LD to close it out here. So I have to see. They want to opt in towards, if they want to force this Weaver in. Personally, I would think it's more likely that they make the Weaver position one and just kind of negate a lot of what this Undying would have to say in the game.
Yeah, I mean, again, playing against Drow, the big thing is gap close, and Dying's all right at that. What do you think about this choice to ban out the Shadow Fiend? It's a nice damage dealer, but is it really that much of a priority?
Oh, yeah. Xiaofing's super good. He's the man. He is, like, good in almost every draft. He doesn't have that many bad matchups mid right now. And then he has minus armor synergy with the Vengeful Spirit, too. Would have had a pre-nit, well, and the Weaver himself, but just a nice all-arounder there. So I'm sure they're pretty pleased they removed that one from the pool. Kuro's still left. We still have our Juggernaut, who's pretty fun. We're going to get an Axe this time. Ooh.
Big initiator. I like that initiator, yeah. Trust taking their time here. I mean, they obviously still need a lot. Unless they're doing something real crazy, like offlane Undying, they're still going to need all their cores right now.
Yeah. They've also shown that with the Undying, well, I guess one of the good things about Undying, although he's kind of single-minded in a lot of the ways that he can play in the early game, like, he likes to fight early, he likes to get some decay stacks, he runs at you. He does mean that you have a little bit of flexibility when it comes to your early lanes. You can't just go mid and sit in, like, a 2v1 scenario and bully out any sort of a greedier mid that Geek fan might go for. So it's not, it's okay to reveal your 4 early if they pressure mid. But generally, if you reveal your 4 early and they don't pressure mid, that's when you tend to run into a lot of trouble lately. Now, Trust will just have to figure out for themselves what they want to do. All they really, like, they basically don't know anything besides Axe is going to be an offlaner.
I'm going to go for a Sand Gink here, another one of those heroes that has been a little bit more neglected now in this patch. Probably going to throw him in the offlane. He can still offlane, I guess. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, they could go for something like a Lifestealer if they wanted to have a really nice vessel for him. 10 seconds
remaining. Yeah, this is sick sanking game, I would say. Yeah, you see the Axe, and you say, okay, well, we know that that's an offlane Axe. That's the only thing we can guarantee out of their heroes. And we know that if we put our sanking in a 1v1, he would do okay against an Axe. It's like, no one does well against an Axe. No one, like, totally dumpsters him 1v1. His Axe can just kind of cause you a lot of problems. But sanking will be fine with that. And then it still allows you to go into this aggro tri-lane if you want with the Rubick and the Undying. But it's by no means a necessity with the hero.
Yeah, Sand King also a good gap closer. If Geek Fam do opt to go back into that drow, they've got another tool to be able to get on top of her and prevent her from just standing there and right-clicking around like a sentry turret. Bounty it's a Geek Hunter. Fam taking their time. They're going to go for a Bounty Hunter here. Very interesting. Just able to scale up pretty quickly. So how nasty bounties can be in game number one of this series. And Trust go for a Luna.
Yeah, this
interesting
makes sense.
Pick.
This would have been, I think, the best one left without Jug here, because it allows them to go into a dual offlane with the Rubick and the Luna, depending if they need to, and they can just, like, send them up there, put the Sand King down bottom, and then Undying can help a mid-hero, potentially. They don't necessarily have to. She also opens up for good aggro tri-lanes as well, just with the aura, or a full zone out onto the Axe as well. It's just, she's so good. I mean, who doesn't love Luna? Look at those eyes. Adorable.
To be fair,
guys,
when I started
Eclipse
playing,
the logo is her eyes.
Whoa!
You guys know that? You're welcome.
Trent Pax, you're blowing my mind here. It's like 6 in the morning. Please,
yeah, that's exploding.
I can't handle.
Yeah. Well, good hero. The Bounty Hunter, this means that there will be a little bit of pressure mid, but it also means they're vulnerable to any sort of an aggro tri-lane coming out from this Luna, so they'll have to be a little bit cautious about that from Geek Fam, and yeah, they'll just take care of that there ticker. So, position one, Weaver. Control elements, they have the Rubick, which is great because he has telekinesis to hold you, and he steals Shikuchi, so he has a fun time, but other than that, it's not too bad. I'll have to watch out for that Sand King. Great Lincoln's game, that is for sure.
Definitely. Trust taking their time with this last ban, making sure Geek Fam don't get their paws on what they want here. Assuming they're still going for a mid. I mean, OD is still in the pool, could do a decent job against everyone, but what do you think?
Geek Fam. A bit of a goon. Like some funny heroes. I guess
Whew. Oh, I like Trust. They've clearly got Trust issues banning out that Ember Spirit, as we saw an Ember Bounty combo just fuck on them in game number one of the first series.
Yeah, that Ember was actually sick.
Just making sure there's no PTSD happening.
10 seconds. And where are we now for Trust? Oh yeah, they're mid laner as well. So Hesby revealed. Hesby against the bounty hunter. Remaining. Jug's gone. Can get a little help from Undying though, and they also have plenty of time to talk about it.
What about like a DK? I think it's so easy to shut Queen down. Like, she has to have a one lane, or it's just not going to work out. They're going to go for a Meepo again.
What? All right.
No, no, right. Okay.
Fair enough. They just got Meepo of their own. They're just like, you know what? Let's do it. It's SEA. I don't know. I just thought, like, the past couple of weeks, Meepo gets banned first phase every game, and then suddenly people ignore him, and he's just gone, and then look at this. Well, they have an axe. They have... pretty much nothing else, and they have 38 seconds to try and figure out what the hell they're going to do against a mid Meepo. Nice pick. Choice. Oh, I guess we don't know these teams, so it's hard to always tell exactly who Meepo players are, but at this point, it's safe to assume every team's a Meepo player. I have to start working him into my repertoire. Their last Meepo game was an attempt up against Faceless. It did not go too well, and they lost the game in 30 minutes, so see if they can get a little bit of a better ball rolling here for Trust.
10 seconds remaining.
An interesting game, to say the least. Meepo and Luna on the same team. I don't see that a lot. Those are two very greedy heroes, but I think Trust have drafted themselves to be able to get the most out of that. But Geek Fam is just like, all right, screw you. They can send the Weavermen if they really wanted to.
And yeah, that can also do that. I'd like to see the Axemen, personally. That'd be pretty great. Run them into the Meepo, but... we'll see. I guess with an Undying there, that sounds pretty awful, so it probably will be the Weaver, sadly enough, but I'll have to see what they want to do. I also don't know who plays the Meepo for Trust. It's going to be one of our scenarios, like with a Bing.
All right, interesting drafts here. I love what Geek Fam did with this last pick. I think they just definitely threw Trust for a loop. I think Meepo's going to be scared because all it takes is kind of one pounce, one lockdown. Slark's probably going to go for that early Echo Saber. Might get a early damage rolling for himself as well. I'm thinking I'm like 70-30 Dire right here. What are you?
Next to Dire?
Yeah, I'm liking their draft a lot. I haven't actually seen Geek Fam play. I've seen their players play individually. Not all on this roster, though.
They looked pretty convincing in their victory. Even okay in their defeat. So I certainly like the squad, this Meepo pick. I don't know. I feel like I've cast like hundreds of games of all these heroes, and then the Meepos have just so recently that I still definitely don't have the best handle on as to how well they're going to do. Difficult to read. Like in that last game, it felt like it was going to go well, but maybe that came down to more playstyle compared to how he, like, they needed to close out because the way they kind of threw their bodies and they, yeah, rather than like chipping away at the victory, they kind of tried to chunk it with these big, like, sacrifice plays. So maybe that's why, but I can give it to a Meepo. It's a ninth pick. Maybe it's desperation. Maybe it's actually good. But yeah, no, I'm trying here, but I think I'm going to favor Geek Fam too. Like, the Blink Dagger will be too slow on the Sand King. And I don't think Luna's going to have enough friends to actually do anything because Meepo's going to be doing other things. So they're like four-man units, kind of weak without Blink Dagger on Sand King. And the Bounty Hunter will just allow them to dodge out any sort of a big group up play.
I mean, I've learned my lesson from watching enough Southeast Asian games that you can never just completely tap out a Meepo. You can never say, like, I mean, he's never going to get online. But we saw in last game how, you know, Meepos can get that momentum going, but unless they can actually finish out the game at a relatively early time, it's somewhat easy for heroes like a Slark and a Weaver to scale up and be able to fight against them.
We're going to have a 747 Dota here. We'll send our Slark mid. I like this. And, I think it was 747 I've seen play Slark mid, and it was in the FDL qualifier versus NP for Northern Arena, I think. Pretty sure. But either way.
Damn, that's a blast from the past.
Yeah, that's a little bit of an older one. Not something we get to see too often. And he'll be going at it, though. Of course, the common mid-matchup of Meepo versus Slark. I won't even elaborate on it because you just all know exactly how it's going to go. So that's not even worth talking about, really. Zone in on this bounty room down bottom. Should be a easy grab here for Velo. No, they're concerned. Wow, I am surprised.
I mean, I guess it's worth just playing safe. You don't want to sacrifice that first blood. Man, that is a cool axe. I haven't seen that one in a while.
Looks like the Not Today logo.
Yeah, I was thinking the staff from Ruby, the anime. But it's all good.
No,
you know,
I'm not one of those anime people, Annie.
Oh no. Don't make it just be me. Now it's weird. All right. Everyone's going to go ahead and collect their own runes. No steals going on. Nothing feisty, but everyone just starting out here. I mean, what lane is the most crucial here to go right or wrong for either team?
Well, it looks like Geek Fam have gotten what they wanted because they made the rotation. Or at least perhaps it's the rain have gotten what they wanted. We can pretty much tell, I would say Sand King personally, because I think that this guy just needs to get a lot done. He wants to have any hope. He'll be up against the Axe, so he can get some farm. Both of them just kind of like burst the waves. It's not a very exciting lane to watch. Yep, there you go. One guy tries to right click, and the other one tries to not.
I think mid's going to be pretty interesting. PP getting punished really heavily. Raji just chilling around. Now Meepo's got to be super careful. Again, got to hit that level 3 point before you can send one Meepo off.
Yeah, he kind of distracted the creeps, though, which allowed them to come right into the tower PB, which is pretty great. Autumn, Sionix, no. 3 more seconds. Should be
a big sandwich going down. He can scooch, yeah, but they've got a sentry placed down, so he's going to have to walk under vision. The problem is just getting those stuns unlocked. They need level 2 on Luna to get that loosened beam.
Top lane, NT is just going to get his way into the tower. So this is the thing. It's like, yeah, Axe just can bully you and stuff like that, and it can be a little bit harder for Sand King, but you can still get a lot of the last hits by using your caustic under tower and stuff and getting those explosions. That's, pretty boring.
PP going to get pounced to mid lane. They've got the damage from Raji. Still only level 1. Are the right clicks there? He's walking his little heart away. Raji got that move speed. PP maybe thinking about the Ancient Deny. Raji doesn't have Janata, doesn't have the Shuriken Toss. He's got to go au naturel on this one. PP making his way towards the shrine and probably is going to get out of this one alive. Bounty Hunter gives up the chase.
That's not too bad though. You force at the shrine. You might even just wait for him to come back too. Oh, of course, the bounty rune.
Oh.
Got it.
Greedy boy. Raji. Very nice.
I'm scared about that top, so. Yeah, again, not too surprising. Now, this is one thing. Whoever can win this abuse is actually winning this lane. Like, but either of these heroes can abuse the creeps and pull them into these neutral camps to farm them up, and that can be the thing that would actually determine who comes out on top in this one.
Lift up from the Weaver, but, I mean, they just don't have enough damage to get him all the way down, just slowly whittling him away. Weaver's just gonna go eat himself a tango. Now what does rotated into the mid lane. Oh, Meepo tired of being completely harassed. Oh, back down bottom, they got it! There we go.
That was all because of a Seder.
Seder MVP, dude. I have seen more than one First Blood come out just because of a Seder blast.
Damn, that actually really hurts for a Luna, too. Just trying to farm up against this stupid lane they brought down up against you. Alright, well, 8 lasses on Sionix. Alright, they're gonna shrine, mostly just for the mana. Just keep up the harass. You're trying to bully Lakels. Lakels, probably the biggest name on this team, at least in terms of people who aren't too familiar with the region, don't watch too much.
Yeah. That guy's been around forever. Plays.
Yeah, exactly. A couple iconic heroes there, namely the
Oh, they're going in. They're gonna be initiating onto the Rubick. He's gonna end up going down. What the? Actually getting pretty low as well. Lakels has the damage, but what the? Even with the fairy fire, isn't able to get out alive. That's a double kill for the Weaver. Meanwhile, up top, Sand King was able to find a kill on the Axe, which shouldn't happen. Our Luna still in some trouble. She's going to try to block her way in with a fancy branch, but still does go down. Raji helping out with all these kills. What the? Gonna go down for a second time. He died and then respawned, TP'd in, and died. Really unfortunate there for the Radiant side.
Yeah, and dying's pretty great when you get these like giant 2 and 3 man decays, you think, but there are also just so many heroes there. PP! Dead. Mid lane dying to Teehee.
And, 1-6 right now is the kill score. It's looking all right for Geek Fam in terms of starts.
Yeah, I would say so.
Yeah.
I got a pretty good grab when you can solo kill the enemy mid who's a Meepo.
And also, you just Slark. Massacred the entire bot tri lane like twice.
Even that top kill is just something that, you know, it's probably just more RNG based. We weren't watching, so it's hard to tell. Maybe Velo was just doing the math and he was like, well, odds are I'll get this kill. And sometimes you just don't get spins. You know, it's the Axe life. Oh, look at
and Seven King, he's found his level 6, so he'll be able to rotate with his crew. He's going to be waiting until at least level 7, level 8 before he picks up the Epi. Would really like to get his paws on the Blink Dagger, but he's got, you know, 2,000 gold to go. It's only 5 minutes in. Another sentry placed down by the Radiant in mid, trying to scout out for Raji hanging around, but he's going to be cautious of this, sticking up to his own high ground.
Now they're trying to help out top lane on Velo once more, trying to keep the punishment going, but not too much you can do. I don't know, I just don't see this going too well for Trust. Just trying to figure out exactly if they can get down with this Luna.
Maybe I mean, Laquelle's just wants out. As much farm as possible, and right now is a pretty good time, as he's just going to be left alone. Raji, meanwhile, scouting out the Meepo's farming, waiting until PP gets low, and might be able to jump him. Has level 1 in Shinata, level 1 in the Shuriken Toss.
Yeah, I'm not sure if PP was pinging because he knew he was nearby or something, but... And the Meepo back, and Bench not going to find anything.
Oh, it could be a nice wrap onto Fei Mao, though. Fei Mao squiggling his way through the trees, actually gets his way out of this one, at least initially. They're just going to be content to clear out the mid lane, maybe chop at the tower a couple of times. TP in comes from the Meepo. And, it's shaping up now. Our Slark ready to rotate. Already has his treads and about 800 more gold to think about at 6 minutes.
Oh, level 3 Rubick, this is so scary.
The Dire Courier just chilling around, trying to either use it as a bait or just forgot about it. But either way, that's going to be Teehee snapping up a kill on the Rubick. Lots of angry ping coming out. Top lane, it looks like Radiant trying to make use of this space, go in, clear out the wave, maybe push onto the tower, but everyone's just staying calm, cool, collected. Down bottom, Laquelle's eating a bug. Tower's gonna be able to shoot that one off, and on the back lines, we've got Crimson, seeing if there's any sort of stun they can go just to nail down the Luna. Best to make her way back home, but she's gonna be able to salve and get herself back to full health.
Well, Ante made his rotation, wasn't able to get anything done on that particular moment. He'll try now from the nighttime.
Ooh, best Psyonix
way for Sand King to
could
anything.
Be in some trouble. They've got that sentry ward if he tries to scooch G out. He's gonna be able to time lapse, but and they've still got vision of him at this point. Oh, Laquelle's though is gonna get completely comboed down. Crimson with a nice missile. Burrow Strike to try to get NT back safely under tower, still chewing on a bug. Leonix gonna be moving forward. Doesn't get the Geminate attack though. The bug is gonna be clipped off in time. Axe goes deep under the tower. Able to get this taunt off onto Fei Mao. Reinitiation from the Sand King, who immediately dies, but it does set up for a successful kill on the Axe. Overall worthwhile. Now there's two very low heroes behind the tier 1 tower. Now they're on cleanup duty, waiting to see if any Radiant heroes are gonna walk past them.
Yeah, at the same time we caught a solo kill mid. Slark grabbing that Meepo once more here. And Psyonix, maybe a little greedy, maybe? I don't know.
They know Psyonix is here, but they don't know Raji's here. So they're trying to bait it in and see if Weaver can draw enough attention that, you know, the low health Fei Mao comes out of the trees. There we go. Swarm popped out. Raji's going to be initiating there. They bring Crimson as well. Magic Missile is going to be available. They're popping it onto the Luna here. A kill on the Luna would be huge. The bug's still doing its work. The Geminate secures a double kill for the Weaver. Fei Mao is still hiding in his little safety bubble down here, but Crimson's got eyes on him.
It's not very safe.
Be able to go through and find a triple kill for the Weaver. Psyonix off to a phenomenal start. 5-0-5 on the bug. And almost a full Dragonlance right now at 8 minutes in the game.
I'll take your and that like all stemmed too from the rotation of the Sand King. When that comes down, like, he just feels this need because you rotate in, you have to do something, right? It was still nighttime. It was probably the best possible moment. And NT missed out on a ton of farm time. At least he is back up top. He's cutting the waves. Good choice up against the Axe. And the race to the Blink Dagger is on.
Yeah, he's got some good progress on it. A death here would really slow him down. The rest of the Radiant Heroes, yeah, they're up top. They got the lift onto the Axe. They might be able to get him down. He goes for a call, catches the Meepos. A couple of lucky spins. Could have been tragic, but it looks like Axe will be the one to bite the dust. Peepee able to snap up his first kill of the game.
And level 6 for Fame now means stolen vanish here. Dire's top tower is under attack. Damn though, he's trying to find something on the back line, not gonna get it. So bounty hunter sets working in towards level 6. Down the bot too, get his raindrops. See if Fame can make anything happen with the Shadow Walk. It's not exactly the easiest game for Rubik. Attack. To get something going. Lakel's probably needs 6 and he's just bailing on this lane.
Xanax able to get the last hit on the tower, so lots of gold going the way of Geek Fam. Feeling real comfortable. Slark, he's gonna be, you know, halfway towards a Shadow Blade already. Blessings
upon a loyal invisibility. Lord. Zone rotations around. It's that's pretty much the I would say the nail in the coffin this game. If Slark can get this going, he gets like 2 or 3 kills. It's going to be very, very difficult for Trust to get back. But at the same time, if he starts getting a little bit too aggressive, getting them anyway for this Weaver, there is a chance that Trust can just turn this around instead of accelerating, moving forward with their Luna and trying to get some big group up plays from there. But first gank, it's actually an Invis rune a little bit early.
Here we go. Peepee went in. He was way deep without vision, farming up this camp up top there. Brought in one of his meatbows. I thought for sure he was going to channel out the poop to get out, but actually brought the rest of his crew in and spelled his untimely demise. This meatbow has not exactly found a phenomenal start for himself.
That's a difficult game for him to find any camps. His own jungle doesn't really feel that safe since they lost the tier 1, so he's trying to like dodge out what he thinks has, might have been smoke plays coming into aggression. Like, a lot of times you Radiant might even feel really smart because you're like up here and it's like, aha, they won't find me here. Or I'd be farming their small camp, but in
mid lane, all of the Radiant Hero are coming in. If they can find a full wipe here, this could turn it in their favor, but a lot of resources being expended right now. A lot of experience being spread real thin. So Radiant has to get something done here or they're just wasting their time. Blink in from the Axe, he goes for the call. There's a track on the Undying, they stun him down. They should be able to find the kill there. Sand King able to channel up his ult. They get the return kill onto the Axe. And now Luna going in with her ult. Psyonix able to go and time-lapse that off, gets stunned down. There they go, bouncing the Shuriken all around. The rest of the Radiant are getting so low, but Slark, he's still alive. The Meepo is still fighting and goes down. That's another track kill as well. Raji getting the most out of his level 6. Raji gonna end up going down. Lakel's getting very low as well. Look at that, Psyonix just doing the damage. Vengeful Spirit helping him out with Wave of Terror. Looking real good for Geek Fam right now. That was, I believe, 2 track kills going their way in that fight. And the Meepo and the Luna, you could not pick more crucial targets than that to get down. Psyonix goes in, not gonna be able to find that tower kill. Swap back, saving Psyonix's life. Crimson, oh, they're gonna turn this into a kill. Oh, this is Geek Fam just having fun. Style points rolling in.
That's painful. What that makes a nice play too. He actually denies that tower, but not going to pay off too much in the end. Now they're just kind of getting pincered and squished in by Psyonix, and then this fresh Shadow Blade on the Slark. They have to be very careful chasing this bounty.
Yeah, they're going in. They would really like to find Raji. Crimson's able to throw out a missile. They got to be able to focus down the Meepo, and they're going to bring in Teehee, and he should be able to do that quite handily. Look at the damage coming out. Crimson's still alive, and Lakel's decides better of going in for another Lucent Beam, but just can't even channel up a Teehee without getting blasted apart. That's 3 more heroes dead on the side of Trust. Once again, the Meepo and the Luna both go down. The kills are not looking great. That's Meepo's 5th death, Luna's 6th.
I had hope when he stole track. Thought maybe this is it. Maybe this will be the big play. He had like 5 track kills. And then right after he stole track, Velo just jumps in and dunked his face. So that was an issue. we also will have our Maelstrom done here for Psyonix. So one of those items that we occasionally see on Weaver, not the most common. But he's seen some value with it here. I have a funny game for it too. I'm not sure. I guess the increased attack speed is nice against the Undying. The magic damage, like, yeah, the zap is kind of cool against Meepo, but of course he has that naturally higher magic resistance. Doesn't help you secure Roche, doesn't synergize with the minus armor all that much. It does help you split push quite a bit though, which might be one of the concerns they have against the Meepo. More wave clear. Hey, Mal, Mike, did you see that?
I melted.
That was depressing. Oh, there goes their Meepo. Got the bounty though. Scouted.
And not going Rubik. Great right now for the Radiant. Looking at overall net worth, it's about 10,000 in Geek's fans' favor, 7,500 in terms of overall XP. I mean, that's against a team with a Meepo that really should be finding a lot of farm, but Meepo is just permanently dead at this point.
I guess solo killed twice in lane. And then the fight started. Geek just started running at them. Shadow Blades, Blink Daggers, and more to come. Echo Saber, only 500 gold away from Teehee as he'll find Lakels.
I mean,
Shadow Dance. I mean, he's just dead. Don't even need it.
I mean, like, what do you do if you're the Radiant? We got Peepee coming in. Peepee, are you a madman? He's gonna be tracked up, and you've got Slark able to go channel up his ult. They might be able to turn this right around. They've got Raji in the area. Gotta be very careful of Radiant Sentry wards, but who are we kidding? Radiant is so freaking poor. They've got one up here near the shrine. It's a nice little ward. They're gonna scout out two Invis heroes, but it's not quick enough for Feimao to get out alive. That's two heroes dead immediately. At least one of them's gonna be a track kill. Another track kill on PP coming back in. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's done. It's all done. Luna's the only survivor making her way past the shrine. Looks like they're just going to be going in for a full wipe. This is upsetting.
Yeah, Lakels is lower farm than the Ventral Spirit. Just got Medallion, stumps into the Solar Crest, and they can easily head into Roche now. Deso or not for a Weaver. They have wards on the shrine too, so yeah, it turns into closeout mode here for the Dire.
I'm a little baffled by the fact that we are now just 16 minutes into the game, and Dire have racked themselves up 28 kills. So, that's fair.
Yeah, they haven't looked like they were struggling or slowing down at all this whole time. Wow, that's
Here we go. Lift onto the bounty. I mean, they're just spending all their energy trying to get Raji down, and it's not even going to be enough. Dire now, they're getting low. Beautiful epicenter from NT. This might just be enough to maybe turn this. They get what they need. They pop the Aegis. Crimson should be going down as well. Looks to turn things around. Everyone going to be going down. The Weaver might be able to make his way up, but now Teehee gets back into the fight. You can go look for pickoffs. The rest of Radiant now running in fear. The Slark is back up. Still really, really good hold there from Trust. They did whatever they could, but it's only slowing down the inevitable, I fear.
Oh, nice. We got a full fight recap as well. So the big bounty goes to the Undying. 1,100 and some, plenty of experience. 34. Big swap over. Man, a lot of gold. So important for sure, but still a long way to go here for the Radiant. But if they can keep up those kind of plays, and they manage to find the kind of like perfect team fights. Feimao just so close, but raindrop's not enough. No track though, maybe? Nice value.
I mean, if that's the only highlight we're looking at here, meanwhile Axe goes in onto the Meepos up top. He's just spinning his little heart away. That was Meepos, again, initiating, poofing into the fight. And meeting their untimely death, the eighth death of the Meepo, in fact.
Yeah, he doesn't have much choice though, because he just, like, one of his Meepos gets called, he's just gonna die if he dishes it, so has to go for the all-in.
Unfortunately, the more Meepos that aggro acts, the more likely he is to spin right in your frickin' face. So it's looking tight for Gifam right now. The track kill's starting to add up, 15,000 gold now, and it's only swooping further. I mean, there's a potential that Geek Fam just kind of lose their momentum and they can't break high ground, but that'd be pretty tricky there. Swap back, they want to go into NT. He had a successful epicenter earlier and they want to get revenge. Dunk miss from the Axe, but they still find the kill. Now Teehee going to draw the aggro from Lakels, but still able to get out. Completely unscratched, still has his ult available if he needs more regen.
Yep, now that's a Mjolnir at 18 and a half minutes. That's Onyx. That's a lot of damage.
3,000 gold soon to be here on our Sark. He's at 26 for now, and I'm not even sure he knows what he wants next. BKB's kind of the dream item, but he might want to just spend the money earlier.
Meepo. Gonna poop all but one meep away. It's gonna be pounced in place, and unfortunately, you can't poop your way out of that one. Call from the axe secures another kill. Meepo has now been in the fountain for almost as much time as he has been out of the fountain.
That sounds fairly accurate, actually, I would say.
I mean, the key to playing a really nasty Meepo is just to be able to go farm completely unnoticed for 20 minutes, but Geek Fam, you look at their lineup and it's just all heroes that love checking jungle camps, that love following you around the map and making sure you don't get that free time. So, I mean, it's real hard to sneakily farm when there's a bounty hunter on your every move.
Yeah, I think Trust knew it must have been a little bit of a riskier pick. The draft they had. This Slark has really worked out well for Teehee, though. I mean, he loves playing these kind of like position ones, I would say, like that Jug again in the mid lane, the PL in the mid lane, and a game where you're given an opportunity to go Slark is be great in itself as well. And yeah, he actually just fully upgrades in the Silver Edge, so less survivability than the full BKB, but he can spend the money right now, get it. He can upgrade his damage, reduce a little bit of the damage, and then just give yourself some more stats, so solid choice. A golden thread.
So Geek Fam, I feel like they've got all the time in the world right now, because let's say they just do absolutely nothing. They just clear out their own jungle and don't cross the river for the next 25 minutes. I mean, yeah, Meepo and Luna can get real big, but Slark, Axe, Weaver, they're all going to benefit hugely from farm as well. So it's not like Geek Fam are facing a crunch right now.
That was not really any sort of concern here.
I want to give a little shout out to our Meepo here. It's been about 2 full minutes and he hasn't died, so finding a little bit of farming experience for himself, staying safe, gonna be all good here. Raji, very, very close to walking underneath sentry vision, but even if he does, he doesn't particularly care. It's not like he's gonna get completely jumped on and blown up anyway. NT, his smoke's gonna pop onto this axe. They do dust the axe, but he just blinks himself right away, so that's gonna be a dust down. At least Trust gets some idea of what's going on the side of Geek Fam.
Yeah, okay. I mean, they're doing what they can. Trying to get Dragonlance. And the smoke will be wearing out soon. It's just Dota, I guess. They just gotta clean it out. 20,000 plus lead. 20,000 approaching on experience.
Looking at the net worth breakdown, I mean, your bounty hunter's going blow for blow with every core on the side of the Radiant. He's one-upping them. The only one that's not completely blowing everyone out of the water is Crimson on the Vengeful Spirit, but she's been doing a great job playing that hard position 5, going for really clutch swaps. The stuns have been great as well, and now she has her Solar Crest. That's the big new hot item of this patch, I feel.
Oh, it's good when you can get a lot of support this early, that's for sure. Snowballing so hard.
Xeonic's gonna be underneath a shrine with no dire wards, but still feeling so comfortable farming all by himself. Mid lane, looks like there's gonna be a track sprayed out onto the Rubick, but he's gonna have to back himself up before anything happens. Right now, this is three heroes channeling up a stun onto Xeonic's. Xeonic's is gonna be held in place. He is able to get off his time lapse. Focus down though, they've got the vision. That's a big kill. That's 600 gold to 4 heroes on the Radiant team.
That's a great play. Basically came just because of like no full vision down here or anything. Lots of D warding, so they know the Dire don't have these like nice cliff wards, could be spotting them out.
Oh, Raji's going in onto the Rubick. Is he going to be able to solo him? Swap away. Wow, swap back in. Kmap wants to book it out of here. Stolen swap. Trying to find himself an escape route, but isn't able to do so. Does rake in a couple of style points. Axe blinks in onto the Meepos that just poofed into the area. Unfortunately, it is still going to spell the death of the Meepos. There's nothing that the Radiant can do to stop this. Full Eclipse channeled out from the Luna, but everyone just sits there and isn't really that bothered by it. Track sprayed out onto Laquelle's now, so more and more gold's going to be going their way. She's able to purge off that track, but... killed anyway. Track back on her.
Godlike there for Teehee.
I mean, this Slark didn't seem particularly, like, way out of control in the mid lane. He just never died, and that was a thing that Meepo, unfortunately, wasn't able to mimic.
I mean, no support help coming from either side. He solo kills Meepo twice. That happens to you in lane as Slark. Very happy guy.
Just on dying, one of the tankier supports in the pool just cut apart like butter. It's looking like Geek Fam are quite unstoppable here. We're probably moments away from a GG. At 24 minutes in, there's about a 30,000 net worth lead, and a full lane of Rax crumbles down. This means no more shrines, and this means super creeps, and Trust don't particularly have great wave clear.
Now they're trying to do something here with the smoke, but
they are fully aware of it happening thanks to the track. Just saw Rubik, you know, vanish. Floating vision. And
Kells. Well, he'll push out bottom. Alright. Saved. So yeah. Grind time. And still Geek Fam maybe just kind of expecting to hear a GG call, but they're not gonna do anything too crazy until they see one. Dagger on our Slark. It is so rich, holy.
Yeah, he's feeling pretty good. Looking at the level breakdown, there's definitely a disparity going on. Axe and Slark have found their level 20s, while Luna is still looking at her level 12, and our Rubik has yet to hit his level 10. Still eagerly looking forward to maybe grabbing up that 60 gold per minute, but I don't think it's happening.
Oh, okay, now. He's struggling with the connection issues today.
Yeah, it's the connection issues. Meepo here, he's continuing to farm up. He's almost got his second Dragonlance done and already has his blink. But for 25 minutes in on the Meepo, I mean, he's just got 10 deaths, and that time off the map, that time not farming, is so big. He just loses gold every death, so he's in Strug City. Meepo, you'd expect to be, you know, 25 minutes around level, you know, 19, 20. He's just ticked his level 16, so even for a struggling Meepo, it's real tough. And you look at what slack there is to pick up, and it falls down to Lakel's on the Luna, and she's having a tough time as well.
Yeah, Lakel's just didn't have anything to help him this game. I don't think this rests on the Luna at all. Like, what are you gonna do as a Luna in that sort of a lane? At least if you're like a Juggernaut or something, you can try and smoke out and try and get a kill with like Omni Slash or something like that, or you can split push more aggressively and use spin TPs. Maybe not against an Axe, but just that whole general idea. Whereas Luna, you don't have those options. You just rely so much more on this whole like team aspect and this group up, or you have Shadow Demon, one or the other.
We just talk about Psyonix's build. I love it so much. This is a build from a Weaver that knows he's completely unstoppable. He went in, got, again, the first item Mjolnir before the Desolator, like you talked about. Now he's going back in for the Deso after picking up a full BKB, still sitting at 10 charges. I mean, Weaver is a really slippery hero to begin with, and now going to be magic immune, going to be juking and jiving all around the fight. You can't kill him. He's got an Aegis.
Yeah, no. Under attack. It's just insurance at this point. Well, at least Meepo's doing his thing, but they should definitely not care about this taunt out. And Kells will go down. Dunked.
It's messy.
Yeah.
Dire, they're securing their lead right now. Two heroes down. Luna doesn't have buyback. Sand King was thinking about going in, channeling up his ult, but will get killed in the meantime. Finally, the GG has come out as Trust just can't take it anymore. They roll over, they call Uncle. And yes, appropriate rip onto the ground. Thank you, Trent.
No problem.
I mean, this could be a repeat of what happened in Series 1 where, you know, Trust got rolled and then came back for game number 2. But Geek Fam are looking incredibly well put together. You can just see the individual skill shine through.
Well, that is game 1, and I'll